Hey dude, come over here. What is it? I found this weird looking brick device. Can you scan it? Yeah, sure. It's an early 21st century cellular telephone. The exact year it can be traced to is 2023, exactly 100 years ago. That's pretty sick, but how do we activate it? I think you press this button and swipe up. Oh, hey, there's a video on it. Well, what are you waiting for? Press play. Oh, all right, I'll do it. Apple recently announced their Apple Vision Pro and the many features it had, and while I was watching the announcement, I started to think of many different types of futuristic technology that we already have, or that we have to wait like 10 to 20 years for. Oh, and I also have Sketch here to join me.
I am being forced to against my will.
First things first, modern computers run on a binary system, ones and zeros. One means on, and zero means off. The way the code moves around is through transistors. For a while now, computer engineers have been making these transistors smaller and smaller so it can have faster data and energy. However, recently we've reached a point where if we make them any smaller, they won't function because of how close the transistors are to each other. Now, what does this have to do with future technology? It's that scientists are working on quantum computers, which don't need to run on a binary system. Instead, quantum computers use qubits, a basic unit of quantum information capable of existing in a superposition of two states simultaneously, unlike classical bits. I'll get into more depth on a superposition later in the video, so just sit tight.
Next up, holograms. Yep, the sci-fi technology you saw in Star Wars or Star Trek is becoming a reality. Actually, they do exist in the form of projectors and augmented reality, and yes, even the three-dimensional holograms exist, but they're still in their baby phase.
On the topic of augmented reality, let's talk about the Apple Vision Pro for a sec. You may think the design of the headset looks pretty goofy, and that's kind of the point. Apple is planning on using that as the starting point and just keep advancing it as time progresses. Over the past few months, you've most definitely heard of AI chatbots such as ChatGPT or Bing AI, and if you haven't, you're living under a rock. I'm not going to go into too much detail about this because, you know, you probably already know a lot about it, but I will say this. I'm waiting for the day that OpenAI becomes self-aware and goes Terminator style on everyone. Because that will be funny to watch.
Enough of that, get that out of here. Let's move on to Neuralink. Neuralink is a brain computer company founded by the Twitter troll himself, Elon Musk. And despite the company being founded in July of 2016, it's only got approved by the FDA in May of 2023. Currently, Neuralink is being used for patients with serious brain diseases. However, Elon wants it to be expanded to the public and have people telepathically talking to each other, which will be very crazy.
Now let's move on to more sci-fi like technology that might be on the horizon sometime soon, such as teleportation. As of now, we can only teleport atoms through quantum mechanics, which is pretty cool. Basically, for an atom to teleport, it would need to be placed in a superposition state, which is the thing I mentioned earlier. Now, what a superposition is, it's when an object is in every possible state of existence at once, and once the object is observed, it becomes one singular state. And what I just described is pretty much what Schrödinger's cat is. The cat is alive and dead while inside the box and becomes one singular state when opened. Anyway, going back a bit, for an atom to be put in a superposition, it would need to be observed. And once observed, it could be teleported to wherever using some fancy tech stuff.
Okay, I did not understand a single word you just said, but anyway, let's talk about hyperloops. It is a concept of future transportation similar to modern-day skytrains, and it is advocated for by none other than Elon Musk. Who would have guessed? Unlike trains, there will be tubes with pods that will be propelled by magnets and pressurized air, and will reach insane speeds. Elon proposed a route that would follow the United States Highway I-5 that goes from San Diego, California, all the way to Blaine, Washington. The normal trip would take 22 hours by car. However, if you took the Hyperloop at a max speed of 1,220 kilometers per hour, you would arrive in Blaine in around 1 hour and 48 minutes. Hey, is this nerdy video gonna end soon? I gotta go back to my home in the UK and start drinking my tea and biscuits.
Yeah, I guess I could end the video here. So what technology are you looking forward to in your lifetime? If you could create anything for your daily life, what would it be and why? Tell me in the comment section below.
I'm still here.
Oh my god, just get in the portal. We've been through this like 8 times. Parked up outside in an old school. The new me back with the OU. The dog always finds his way back home, and it's so true.